I'm Jane. I'm currently the marketing director for Tooth Ryland in APAC and EMEA, and welcome to another episode of our What Makes Us Tick expert interview series. So for this episode, we are going to focus on a very, very important topic, which is medical device safety. I mean, it is a matter of life and death. How do you know that the medical devices that you're using at home or the ones that the doctors are using on you are safe and reliable? So all of us are right now in various degrees of lockdown or quarantine by the government due to COVID-19 pandemic. And we could see from news everywhere, there is shortage of medical equipment. Manufacturers are trying to keep up with this elevated demand. So how can we ensure that even in pandemic times or even not pandemic times, that the safety and reliability of our medical equipment? So today, I'm very, very excited to introduce to you and welcome two of our experts in medical device testing services. One is, the first one will be Dr. Mohan Cherley. He is the Vice President of our Medical Device Services in Tooth Ryland. And we also have our technical expert all the way from Japan, Mr. Oshiki-san. So how do we ensure the safety of medical equipment? One thing that we can look at is please test your devices to IE 60601, or when you are using a medical equipment, check that it has its IEC 60601 certification. An oversight of any compliance standards can only be very costly to the manufacturers, other than the fact that it is a matter of life and death in the areas of product redesign, compliance testing, device approval, and certification around time. Please ensure that you know what IEC 60601 is so that you can expand your market access and certify your new products now. I'm now going to hand over to Dr. Mohan Cherley as he is going to give us an overview of what IEC 60601 is. So Dr. Cherley, thank you so much for joining us today. So currently we know that there are a series of technical standards that are available globally, international standards that are important to ensure the safety and performance of medical electrical equipment. And IEC 60601 is one of them. Will you be able to share with us a little bit more, in layman's term, please, about IEC 60601?
So for all active medical devices, in other words, for all electrical medical devices, the IEC 60601 is the basic standard, is the standard for safety and essential performance, which is published by the International Electrotechnical Committee, IEC. So, and this standard can be split into two parts. The first part of the standard is covering all the general requirements, and which is, for example, usability, alarm system, or electromagnetic disturbances. This three examples covers are valid for each electrical medical device or active medical device. Yeah. The second part of the standard is the so-called particular part of the standard, which covers specific medical devices, for example, dialysis machines, imaging devices, or ventilators. For example, if you want to test a particular medical device like a ventilator, we would like to measure, for example, the airflow in and outside the body. So this is a particular requirement for a ventilator, which of course is not applicable for an imaging machine.
So thank you so much, Dr. Cherley, for sharing with us, you know, a quick overview, a very high level overview of what IEC 60601 is. So, you know, Dr. Cherley, the hot topic that everyone is thinking of right now, everybody's affected by is the COVID-19 pandemic. And, you know, we see from the news on a daily basis on the importance of one of the most important medical equipment is actually the ventilators. You know, now there is no actual antidote for the virus. We are all now, you know, focused on getting vaccines. Can you share with us, for those of us who are not in this field, what is a ventilator? How does it work? And, you know, what medical purposes do they have? How does it help us?
So first of all, we have to differentiate between home use ventilators and the so-called clinical use ventilators. For the home use ventilators, for example, we have the devices which are used to help with sleep apnea. And other devices for home use are, for example, to offer basic oxygen support. So the other part of the ventilators we have to consider are the, as I said, the clinical use ventilators. And here we have, again, two different types of clinical use ventilators. The first one are the so-called emergency ventilators, which are basically used in emergency cases during transport or at different altitudes. So the critical care ventilators, which are the second ones in the clinical care ventilators, are those who are used under the clinical environment to treat acute respiratory distress syndrome, which is the main cause of death among COVID-19 patients.
So thank you, Mo, and thank you so much for sharing with us, you know, how the different types of ventilators and what kind of roles they play in medical treatment. So coming back to our topic about ensuring the safety of a medical equipment, can you maybe share with us and apply the concepts, the standards of IEC 60601? How do they ensure the ventilators are safe to use across different countries?
So actually, the IEC standard 60601 is an international standard and is considered as the international standard globally. So there are no particular country differentiations between countries. So when you ask for a particular part of the standard covering ventilators, especially when we talk about critical care ventilators, this is covered in a particular standard with the ending -2-12. So now it gets a bit complicated and don't want to confuse you, but the IEC 60601 particular part -2-12 was originally published in 2001 and is meanwhile replaced by the latest version of a standard, of a so-called ISO standard, which have the same ending, -2-12, but has is called 80601. So this is the difference and to the IEC standard, and it's the most actual particular standard covering critical ventilators from 2020 and also incorporates experiences from ongoing COVID-19 pandemic.